Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is VTech Guy. I'm here with good old Dane and Molense because my son and the man that is formerly known as the defunct and debunked Alpha Sports Gaming decided to hop out. But it's okay. We're talking Backlash, May 21st, 2017. Don't hinder with gender.
They couldn't hinder him forever.
Wow. In a pay-per-view that might actually be one of the worst pay-per-views of this year, I was excited how it ended because I didn't think they would do it. None of the matches really impressed me. I disagreed with some stuff in terms of, I think Aiden English probably should have got the win over Ty Dillinger because Ty Dillinger will long, I think long term Ty Dillinger will be more successful. Aiden English, I feel like, needs this now or else he may never get it. In terms of that pre-show match, the opening match with Shinsuke and Dolph was a little too long in my opinion, and it felt slow actually too. Like, I don't know, it felt like Kevin Owens was running around faster than Shinsuke, but it was decent. Shinsuke wins because why would Dolph ever win? Breezango and the Usos was great. It was probably match of the night, but the sad thing about it was Breezango didn't get the win. Even though they played off the fact that, you know, they Tyler Breeze was undercover as a janitor, as you know,
and a grandma,
as a grandma, and it was really great. But in the end, they didn't get the win, and that's sad there, because I thought that could have been their big moment. They could have had, you know, a lot of fun and ran with it. But not.
Oh, hitting JBL with the dress thing?
Yeah. One of the Usos threw a dress straight at JBL. JBL had a rough night. He got, like, the Shearers thrown at him, too. So, the women's match happened. Bad Girls win. That's all you gotta know. Wasn't really that good. What else? Sami Zayn beats Baron Corbin for some freaking reason. Doesn't make sense to me.
That was before, but yeah.
Yeah. And Luke Harper beats Eric Rowan. Doesn't make sense to me.
But yeah, the Kevin Owens thing was very disappointing. It ended with a fucking count out.
Yeah, it ended with Styles getting his leg caught up in the announce table and Owens getting the win there and then super kicking him in the back of the head and walking out. So, good thing there, Owens retaining the belt. I think that will help him long term. But AJ with the U.S. belt, I think that'll happen eventually. I'll say that. So, main event time in a match that was long too, but had a lot of just like small moments in terms of Randy Orton beating the living piss out of the Shearer brothers or the Singh brothers, whatever you want to call them. It was great in terms of that, but it wasn't like a technical masterpiece. But I think there's definitely the aspect of having a lot of fun with Jinder as champ to be made, especially because Orton is champ, you know. There's only so many times you can do it. And Jinder is champ.
Randy throwing them around was entertaining. When he threw around the managers and he was beating the crap out of
them. He nearly killed one of them because the referee was like, dude, you okay?
But he nearly killed that one.
Yeah. The ending came when Randy Orton decided to attack both of the Singh brothers with that, you know, DDT off the ropes he does, you know, when they're hanging off the ropes. I think it was a guillotine DDT or something like that. I don't know, but he hit both of them with it, and then Jinder Mahal comes behind, hits his finisher, and Jinder's champ. You freaking just roll with it. Run with it. It's crazy. This is probably going to be a short review, honestly, because it wasn't good. It wasn't a good pay-per-view. I'm just excited Jinder won.
I'm just still on that high, like, yes.
Yeah, but in all honesty, though, if Jinder didn't win it and Randy would have won it, I would have been like, all right, they didn't take a leap.
I would have probably gone to bed. We might have not even done the review.
They didn't take a leap anywhere, so there wasn't too much craziness.
The thing is no titles would have changed at that point, so it would have been like, what was the point even this pay-per-view at that
NXT,
point? Because the rest of the match,
TakeOver Chicago is far better.
The non-title matches sucked.
Mm-hmm. The crowd was good. The crowd was really good.
The crowd was decent.
Good.
I don't know if I heard any CM Punk chants.
Big props to Chicago. Chicago the last two nights has been incredible.
They kept it classy.
they were booing the heels like they were supposed to. They were giving
they were doing what fans are supposed to do. Like they were giving, they kept it classy, they were yelling
at freaking Aiden English and freaking Dolph Ziggler. They were pissed when those two came out.
Yeah, it was funny to see like some of the reactions when Jinder won the belt. Like the one kid who was like, really, you know, some
yeah,
of the people,
one kid looked real
some
angry.
Of the people in the
Dude, that kid's
of the
gonna
women.
Grow up to be racist.
they literally look like they saw Undertaker lose at Mania for the first time.
Yeah, like that. Yeah. It was literally like the looks on the people's faces was the same looks you saw in the crowd when Undertaker lost his first match against Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania 30.
Yeah.
People were wondering, is this real? John, like, people were almost there. Everyone was even in the call that when we were all watching it. Everyone was sitting here, like everyone was waiting for Shane or something to come out and just piss
Daniel
all
Bryan
over this moment
yeah.
where we're just all hyped.
Hyped.
John, did you watch the pay per view?
Yes, the whole thing.
What would you,
John? Did
you
love the ending?
What would you give this pay per view? Like, what were your thoughts on it? I'm curious.
Because
you weren't here on the call for most of it.
Thoughts? I completely enjoyed it. I did the whole coverage via Twitter and Instagram.
Yeah, I saw the Twitter.
It was pretty phenomenal to me. It wasn't the greatest pay-per-view, but I would definitely give it an 8.5.
Oh, that's ballsy. Dane, what would you give it?
Out of 10?
Yeah.
Maybe a 6.5, maybe a 7.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere around there.
Honestly, I'll give it an 8. If Jinder would have lost, it would have probably been like a 2. It was that knocked it up 6 points.
Yeah, and honestly, like if Jinder would have lost, I probably would have been like 3, but I'm feeling
there'd have been no
right
point
now.
For this pay-per-view if Jinder would have lost, because at this point you had to have one of the two titles change hands.
Yeah.
Either the tag titles with Breezango winning it, or you had to have Jinder win. You had to have one of those underdog teams.
Mm-hmm. Something that like we of course love Jinder. Jinder's freaking wonderful.
Yeah.
Don't
Jinder.
I
love his gimmick. I think that he's playing it well, and he's
getting
he's
the opportunity
doing everything,
and he's running with it.
He's doing everything you can to be to redo his last run in the WWE. He's doing everything you can. You can tell he's working his ass off, and you can't do anything but love that.
I thought that tag team match was pretty hilarious.
That was,
yeah,
I like said
that
match
was great.
Of the
oh, the
yeah,
tag
in my opinion.
Team match was great comedy. I love the fact that they decided to turn Breezango, because I'm guessing we're gonna go with the fact that they're faces now.
Mm-hmm.
Love this. I want to see more of the Fashion Files. The Fashion Files is hilarious. I honestly think it should be like a thing that they should honestly have like a little mini series on the network.
I thought it was pretty hilarious when JBL finally cleared the air by saying, "Don't worry, Tyler Breeze was grabbable after all."
Yeah, Fashion Files on WWE Network would be great. I agree with
that. Yeah, I love that little segment. I completely enjoyed it.
Yeah, sad they didn't win it, but like I said, pay-per-view-wise, I give it a 6. It was just, it wasn't great, but Jinder winning the belt definitely saved it, in my opinion, because it's not Randy, it's a heel champ. We're going to get something different, because honestly, the only good part about Randy as champ was his feud with Bray Wyatt, because what would have been next for him? I mean, maybe AJ, but AJ turned face, so now it's like, eh. So, with Jinder's champ, we open up the door to, I mean, the Randy Orton rematch is obviously going to happen, but we get, you know, AJ Styles and Jinder, maybe. Trying to think of who else. My mind's going numb. I mean, we could get Shinsuke and Jinder, which would be like, what the heck? That's random. But
Cena.
Cena, there's the big one.
Cena, yeah.
I didn't want to mention Cena
one.
Yet,
because
I think that's SummerSlam. I think that's like...
You'll see him at SummerSlam. Yeah. Right now, it's interesting who's going to get the... Do we see a Randy Orton rematch, and then we see him lose again, and then we see Jinder versus Cena at SummerSlam?
Maybe.
Super Cena?
Oh, no shit. We got two pay-per-views technically for SmackDown before SummerSlam.
What is it?
Don't they have one in June and July?
I don't know. I don't know. But until then, everyone, keep it safe.